Good morning, ma'am. I'm Rishik. So,
good morning, Rishik.
Good morning, ma'am.
You are the one who going to take the interview.
Yes, ma'am.
You look so young. How old are you?
I'm 14 years old, ma'am.
Oh, great. 14 years, Rishik is taking interview. How did you get the interest in this?
My aunt, she gave me an opportunity to participate in writing articles for Allies for Her. So that's how I got this opportunity, ma'am.
Very nice. Very nice, Kanna. All the best.
Thank you. So good morning to all of the viewers. We have Ms. Jayashree Mooga. She is the state secretary for BJP. And I'm going to ask her a few questions about her experiences in the political field and also about her how she developed her leadership, what obstacles she faced, and what is her opinion on her opinion and views upon women participants in the political field. So thank you, ma'am, for sparing your time. Shall we start?
Yes.
Ma'am, so my first question to you is, what is your role as a state secretary in BJP?
State secretary means I'm an office bearer in state executive team. So in that, this state office bearers, all the EC members will represent the state Bharatiya Janata Party, political party, so which will execute everything in the state level. So everything means whatever the central party and the state party decides going into the field, working with the cadre and working for the welfare of the people, and whatever the party interest will be there, party line, we will call it as party line. Whatever the party lines are decided, that we will take it forward to the people. People, public in general, and then specially for our cadre, means political, our cadre will be there in village level also, from state to village level also, they will be there. So the design, the activities, whichever will be decided by the party, that will be taken to the village level. So to do that job, some steps will be required and persons will be required to take it into the district levels. For that, we will be assigned, the work will be distributed among the team, and a few districts will be given in charge, or few villages will be given in charge. The criteria of distribution of work will be different in for different activities. Like calendar of events, we will go as a guest. Like press meets, we will go as a guest. And if election is there, we will go as an in charge. So the action or whatever work we do, it will be based on the activity taken up by the party. So throughout our tenure, we will be doing like this. The specific job role will not be there. According to the party line, we have to work.
Got it, ma'am. So coming to the next question, why did you get interested to participate in the affairs of the state, and how was there any specific event which made you more interested?
Specific interest, it's nothing like that. So basically, with aren't a proper planning only, I have entered into the politics. Some incident made me to work coming into politics. It's not like that. So because a planning means basically we have to go a little bit background of my beginning of the career and all this. So I am a I'm a social entrepreneur, basically. My original nature is I'm a social entrepreneur. So because of that only, I have worked for, I have started one educational institution, which is in a high school. 15 years I have run Telugu medium institution. We have run with 1,000 students average. So that was a very good experience. So choosing that sector also is my interest only, the education, working for education. And then another 15 years I work simultaneously. Simultaneously I worked in health sector also. I have run as an administrator, I have worked for one 50-bedded hospital, that is health sector. So then again simultaneously we have started this an NGO, voluntary organization. We have started, that is also interesting, social sector. So all these things we were showing my interest towards the where we can, I can serve people more, education, serving children, health, serving people, and NGO is also serving people. So directly whichever activity is connected to the people, in that I was interested. So all these 15 years of health sector, 15 years education sector, and 24 years in NGO sector, this made me to think so much, why can't we enter into politics? Politics need so many experienced people. So with that background only, experienced people, because as an education, running an educational institution or hospital, we can do very little amount of service we can do to the people. And in health sector, education sector, in voluntary sector, there are so many things we can do. Government can do a lot for people, but for our surprise, or our political system, basing on the our political system, it is not in the right track. So I thought experienced people may contribute something to the system. A system comes out of political parties, so why can't we join political party? So that was the background of my joining into the political party. That there I have chosen Bharatiya Janata Party, which has values in what way I think, and my school is also from Shishu Mandir. I have got the experience with RSS and other value-based education I have seen. So all these things have been attracted me to join Bharatiya Janata Party.
Ma'am, so how did you build your experience to pursue a career in politics? Like, what did you study? What are the different initiatives you took? Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. Oh, experience also, as I told you now, all this health and education, voluntary sector, we have worked for environment, women, gender issues, children, child issues. CWC, I was working for a child welfare committee president. I was there for 6 years. So all these made me to think so much, and this experience I want to really put into a proper channel where I can contribute my experience to this. And in these 24 years of experience, definitely I feel I am a little bit enlightened in few things, where I can work for the people. I can decision makers, I can influence the decision makers. I can influence the manifesto, in making the manifesto. So these are so many things where ultimately, all the system is running through political parties, so whichever is in the power. So there, if the party is in opposition also, they can influence the sitting party, running party. And whichever is in power also, if we are in power, there also we can influence. So for that, I thought experienced people, more experienced people must be there in the political system. So my experience to the grassroots, definitely it has contributed me to get into the politics. And then that experience is definitely making me to do, in political system also we can influence people. People who are working for the party, not only I can do everything. It's not like that. Those who are working, others are working for the party, and this kind of vision, grassroots vision, may not be there. They might be good leaders, but the experience may not be there. So if I sit with them, we can discuss with them. If I can contribute my experience to the other leaders, that also helps us. So in that way, my experience is useful to the party and in turn to the public.
So what do you like the most about being a politician, ma'am? Like, what makes you the most satisfied?
If you come to satisfaction, means I'm not at all satisfied. Satisfied means how you measure the satisfaction. Getting into politics, whether it is right or wrong, means I'm right. I don't have any regrets. So I am doing my job, and the objective which I kept for myself, joining into the party, there I am happy. And in that, I don't have any part. Satisfaction means the level of contribution I wanted to do, the main objectives which we want to get into the system. These things we are unable to do because my role as a secretary is very minimal. And contributing as a secretary will not give anything, and will not change anything in the party. Maybe, as I told you, like leaders living together, interacting with others and with the party cadre, there I may get, I may be able to get some difference. So building them a leadership, definitely I'm working for the leadership building in the party cadre, taking classes, training classes for them with my experience. There I'm really satisfied. Training classes for the young emerging leaders who are in village, mandal level leaders are there. They're into the training classes. So there really I'm satisfied with that activity. That wherever constructive activity is not there, I'm a little bit unhappy with that. So in political system, every step will not be in a constructive step. As we work with the goals in NGO sector, or it's not an NGO. So every activity cannot be having an aim, objective, and deliverables like that. It will not be there. So in that way, okay, little clash of working system. So there I may not be satisfied. Otherwise, I'm okay. So that that is making me, and building leadership. My role in building leadership is making me a little bit satisfactory, and little changes by being contented without running around the post, without running for the power, building the only confining to building the leadership, building the party cadre, building the party as a next alternative strength in the state, in that, participating in that, really I am satisfied.
So in your years as part of BJP or in your political career, what are the challenges that you have faced?
Challenges means, sir, generally, my nature, right? Challenge, once we accept one, when we are working for a goal, challenges are inbuilt, rather. So inbuilt challenges will be there. When I entered into the politics itself, so many challenges will be there, definitely. Especially women will have more challenges than men. Family-wise, a challenge. Not giving proper time to the family. That is also one challenge. So, sparing more time, irregular timings will be there. That is also one challenge. And proving ourselves on par with male persons, it is also a challenge. And even after working on par with males, recognition will not be there. That is also one challenge. So all these, so many inbuilt challenges will be there if we have one goal. So I think we have to accept them. Accept them and then we have to face them. So those challenges, I never, precisely I never thought of it. And as a part of my role, I am taking it, I am taking it forward. So challenges, definitely, there are more challenges will be there for the women especially. So and discrimination will be there. Yeah.
Ma'am, so I believe that you have already answered my next question. Like, do you think there are more challenges faced by women than men in the political stream? So you said yes. So like, did you face any discouragement or were you targeted by the media? How did you overcome such obstacles like this?
So I can elaborate that. So the female have more challenges than men, definitely. So there here, some problem is for, with the females. Males who are enter into politics, they will have freedom. Freedom means not what freedom you want, freedom means it's not like that. Career-wise freedom. They can enter anytime, any age, without having, without earning anything, without doing anything also, they can just like that, they can come and join and they can work for the party. But whereas women cannot do that. And those, and basically major obstacle for women is getting into politics. An educated woman and well-educated families from well-educated families, women coming into politics is definitely an obstacle. They think all political women are not good. They are not acceptable. This is a general impression people will have. So for educated women with a good family background, if somebody wants to come into politics, first resistance will come from the family. And then society treats it in a different way. And within the party, you will get the treatment in a different way. So these are the major challenges. First, entering into the politics itself is a major challenge for an educated woman. Then, after entering into the politics, how we are working and what for you are working and how you want to get your things done is also a big challenge. Things done means if I want to get one post, say, now I mean as a secretary, to get this secretary, what I did means I have done 24 hours into 7 work for 5 years. Kind of work. 24 hours into 7 means that regular working hours, 10 to 6. So, major time contribution, experience contribution, all those things we have done. So, in that, with experience, I got this and I'm happy for that. They have recognized and gave. But for every woman, it may not happen. The recognition may not come. So then the disappointment will come as a chain process. When one lady enters into the political system, she may not be recognized. She may not have experience to how to work. That is also a major obstacle. major challenge, how to work, how to go ahead, how to take forward, meeting senior people every day and going with them around. That is also a big challenge. If one lady moves with one senior person, that leads to some other problem. So that is also social stigma problem will come, and that leads to some other issues. So these are anti delicate issues will be there for women to move around. So proper planning, and without planning, without proper work contribution, a woman getting into the system is very difficult than men. So men without education, without proper experience, without this thing also, they can come, because they can move around anywhere. They can move with anybody. Wherever they want to go, they can go. Anytime they want to go, they can go. So there is no obstacle for women, for men. Whereas women has these kind of challenges. So they have to attend all these things in general, and then move forward with their goal or objective, whatever they want to achieve. So, and discrimination will be there. Exploitation also will be there. Politicians are not on par with anybody. So here also exploitation will be there. So these are the challenges will be faced by women. And media wise, if I take media wise, media, I didn't have any problem with media because I'm not keen in getting myself into media and look in different channels. So all those things, I'm not keen on that. And I never faced any problem with them. But at the same time, they never did any attempt to get proper leaders into the limelight. So that I have a complaint with the media, but otherwise, sincerely, everybody offered me to get into media and give some time for talking to media and all those things. But I am more interested in field, so I never faced anything.
So, ma'am, what do you think the media can do so that the political stream can be made better? Like, how can it help in spreading awareness? Or how, as you said, how can it bring young generation who are aspiring to become politicians or join the political stream, like how can they bring them into limelight? What are your suggestions or your viewpoints about the media?
Media has a very big role, really big role. If they think they can change the entire country, and they can change the entire country. So, but the unfortunate thing is they are not playing their role properly. So corruptive media is going on, and then they look for their incentives, like whatever we get some viewers more, and then we cannot blame media also. People, if one news they have given, one negative news, if somebody has given, that is played and many viewers are seeing, that means people are attracted to negative issues. So people are, media is not at all into constructive work. Constructive work they are not encouraging, because if only they are running around the viewers. So if we ignore viewership and all of these things, then the original content will come. So, basing on the viewership, if they go, definitely some accident has become, some problem has come with one male-female relationship, or some exploitation issue is going on. Those things, they're all negative things. In a society, in a family itself, all four people are different. So in a society, there are good, bad, everything will be there. So if you promote good, good will increase, goodness will increase. If you promote negative, negativeness will increase. So media is running around propagating the negative things more than positive things. So positive things are not, and then even channels, papers are owned by few parties. That is also very bad. That should not be there. Any media, one investment may come from some political people because they may be rich, they may be investing or the, whatever it is. The background, the ownership may be some leaders, but the ethics by media should be followed in generally. The people's interest will be the major objective for the any media, paper media or print media or this visual media. But they are not at all following it. If they play a role with ethical system and not owning one person or one party, non-controversial things they get into public, and the social entrepreneurs, real entrepreneurs, scientists, young people like you. So can anybody imagine a 14-year-old boy taking an interview of a political leader? It never happens. If we depend on media, some your close relatives have identified your talent and then gave a chance to you to take up the issue, and now you are with me, and how nicely, how maturely you are taking the interview. See, and this is an example, live example I am giving. So there are so many people in village level also. If you take one village as a unit, you will get every specialist in that. You will find one scientist, you will find one journalist, you will find one successful farmer, you will find some 99% 100% educated people. Everything will be there. Many aspects, one village will be covering so many entrepreneurs, so many different multi-talented people will be there. So not even one village is identified and exposed. Not even one person is identified or exposed. The work which they can do, they are not doing in a bigger manner. Maybe one or half an hour they might be giving in the whole 24 hours, half an hour they may be giving a chance, but it is not going like that. So the constructive work which media can do in a bigger way, it is not being done. So that has to be changed. Definitely they are not playing up to the mark.
Ma'am, so what are the ethics that you follow as part of the political system?
Ethics means it is a bigger subject. So ethics differ from profession to profession. If you take a medical side, we take, there are different ethics. If you take education, there are different ethics. If you take political system, there are different ethics will be there. So ethics are not common to all professions. So in political system, I feel many people are not following the ethics. So definitely that has to be changed. In political system also, it has to be changed. For that purpose only, I suggest many people, educated, experienced, who can work ethically. Working ethical people should come, enter into the politics. So then the system will change. If the system changes, everything will change. If the political system or governance changes, everything will be changing. So there, ethical people should come into the politics. So here, political ethics will be different. definitely means ethics different means if I have a we if we take this cashless transaction, that is an one movement taken by the government. If that change that gets the total country into a value based system, that is one move taken by the government. So if we if party people and other in general public, if we all follow those cashless system, there won't be corruption, will be reduced. 50% corruption will be reduced. So but we are not ready for that. So how we are following your ethics principles, even from individually I have to follow that system, and then as a party people everybody has to follow, and in general public should follow. So here we are following it. Maybe in practical day-to-day problems we may not follow that. So ethical behavior means we are trying to do that. 90% we want to go for cashless transaction, so that we are following it. So that is one way of getting ourselves into ethical system, whichever is good for the people. So in political system also, this kind of ethical system should be followed. And to getting my post, stubbing some other person or ditching some other person and getting my post is unethical. So that should not be there. That should not be there. Earn your post with your own capability. So these are it is very broad subject if we take. So definitely to my extent I am 100% following ethical I am following ethical values, whichever has to be followed in political system, definitely I am following them. And I am trying to bring other my youngsters into the political system and training them to do and giving space to grow. That is also giving growth to the next person is also a ethic. We have to follow one ethic. So if you are, I want to be a leader till my death, that is not correct. That is not an ethical system. So if I am a leader, I have to develop leaders. So if I am one leader, I have to develop hundreds of leaders and develop them and get them into the society. But where that no, if I am a leader means I have to grow and I have to be there to, like this also I have to be there till my village. That is unethical. So bringing the leadership into society and growing them is also an ethical value. So that definitely I think I am a value based leader. I claim myself as a value based leader.
Ma'am, so what studies did you do to join the political career? What did you study after school, and what do you suggest the youth to study or to have knowledge of before they join the political stream?
Getting back to this thing, I have studied my Bachelor of Science and then Bachelor of Law. So those two degrees gave me definitely confidence when I entered into some career, this school or hospital, NGO, or I both law graduation and science graduation, they have made me to work with some confidence. But after entering into these institutions, definitely my experience gave me more education than the degrees. So in my experience in this particular three sectors, NGO sector, health and education sectors, definitely I have studied in depth different categories of the society, categories from destitute women, destitute children, child rights. I have worked for child rights, women rights, and then the activities are going on, and then self-employment promotion, because I don't believe in government jobs. Depending on government jobs is not correct. So if the country has to grow, our GDP has to grow, the entrepreneurship should grow, and more industries, more experiments, more innovations should come into the society, and they should be encouraged more. So that in those areas I have worked more. And climate change issues, we are our in NGO our main focus was on climate change. So there are so many in climate change, so many issues, plantation, groundwater, pollution, there are so many issues were addressed in that particular area. So all these things are put together. Society needs a lot of support from the government. So that government emerges from the political system. So it is a chain process. So my study, if I can be in a good position to contribute something to the society in a bigger way, what I did, I am really satisfied. I am done for my life. This study wise and my contribution to the society, really I am happy. If something happens to me today, I am with full satisfaction, I will leave my soul. So I will leave my body. So that is my satisfaction level. But when we are living further, this should give me some logical conclusion. This experience should be given to forwarded to next generation, means it should be in a bigger platform. So I have chosen this political party as a bigger platform. So in this party also, it requires all these inputs to be added to our activities. So definitely it is my experience and my studies are useful for the party.
So we can say
my extent.
Yeah, we can say that your studies and your experience together helped you build your confidence in the political career.
Yes, definitely.
So one of my questions is that what were your aims when you joined the political party BJP? Were you able to fulfill your aims?
I want to be a change maker in particular area, and which wherever I am working. So change maker means what do you mean by that? Means so a person working for getting one post, power center post, that is also one power center post is different. And a person working for who thinks to work for the people, and to working for the people getting one post is different. So that is self-centric, and this is public-centric. So self-centric work I don't like. So in political parties, self-centric work, if I am working, I am doing my job. All these years I have done my job with all these experience which I got from that. You know, I am working for my family also, to earn some perks also, to contribute to some of the perks to my family also. But at the same time, if we come to political party, power-centric party, if you come with personal and self-centric goal, if we come, that will not serve to the society. So there is a difference between these two things, self-centric and public-centric. So I came to the political party with public-centric vision, not my self-centric. I don't have any personal goals. I don't have any personal goals. So public-centric means public, making building leadership, building values, building ethics, building system in the party. All this comes into the public centric only. If the system is running properly, the delivery, the next level will take in a different way. If the system is not working properly, the even the second cadre workers also will be like, and then the third cadre also will work like that. So the flow chart should come with a systematic way and with a value based way, with a plan, proper vision. It should come percolate in a different way. So with this second category, I will come, not self centric category. So I'm okay.
So finally, ma'am, after this discussion, what would you recommend to the aspiring women political candidates?
I have a lot to tell women who wants to enter into the politics. First thing, having dreams and having a vision of imagining ourselves as a leader, nothing wrong. Nothing wrong. We have to work for that, undoubtedly. But a woman having that particular goal without proper planning, without taking care of their family, somebody is only career-based if they come, I'm not for that. Because ultimately, family matters. So in that particular, if we take a woman from family, coming, she comes from some family. So the woman has a some particular role in the family. Definitely if her husband or parents, they are taking care of their responsibilities, that is fine. Nowadays, boys have changed. The family system also a little bit changing. Men or boys are sharing their responsibilities. It is there. But at the same time, if somebody is not sharing and then ruining the family and getting into the politics, I don't prefer. I don't suggest. First preference is family and then your vision. Family means convince them, or at least you come finish your responsibility, or have a proper plan. And before entering into politics, a woman should have their financial status proper. Otherwise, financial status means at least a family should be in a position to feed them. So earning from political career, if they plan and then they move and then they invest, and then if they don't get, they get disappointed. Or to get the things done, they will be exploited. These are the she will be falling into vicious circuit. So without proper family support or financial background, if they enter into politics, and it will be a difficult challenge. Challenges are everywhere, but very difficult to face the challenge, and then in this difficult circumstances to achieve and or prove, she may be getting into some traps also. Trap may be financial trap, trap may be exploitation trap, some different traps will be there. For women, the trapping is very easy. Getting into the vicious, I can say it as a vicious circle. So she will be entering into vicious circle. So that should not be there. If that should not be there, means your planning should be proper. Planning should be proper means your supporting system should be proper. If your supporting system is not there, getting into and I will go and become a leader means waste. Then if individually, if you are not happy, then your delivery will also will not be in a proper way. Your mind or physical fitness must be in a proper position to deliver some good activity. So for that, you need some healthy mind, healthy system in your background. So I suggest women who wants to aspire a political career, definitely they can take. And the system needs many women political leaders that too educated well knowledgeable women it requires. Only they can change the system and they can protect the women who are outside the party and who are living in villages, who are more vulnerable, exploited. There are so many issues are going on, you can see. So to protect them, the women, the proper women leadership be in the political parties. So aspiring is not at all a problem. Proper plan, come with a healthy mind, a healthy background, and then deliver your service and then get your object, get your goal, get into your goal, then it will be fine. If vested interest of financial earning or anything will if you have, then definitely I don't suggest to enter into that. If you have financial goal, do some business. You can do. Many women entrepreneurs are they are very good in real estate. Real estate is a very common thing that I am telling. So real estate is there, some chain sales points are there, cooking centers. These things I am talking about, illiterate people I am talking about. So they have very good business mind, women have. So we can do business. Not into earning money, entering into politics, definitely don't do that. Especially women should not do that, because you will be exploited. So that should, if one woman is exploited, 10 women will go back, their families will pull you back, because see how that lady is doing, how she has been exploited. Is it necessary you to go get into politics? So the pulling will be like that. So if you do one mistake, the hundreds, thousands of families will be watching you, and then they will pull you back. So that should not be the case. So let us have an good leadership. Definitely women leaders are very good. They can perform very well. Since original nature of women is dedicated, nature will be there. Definitely they will perform well, and I really invite them, and they can explore their leadership qualities.
Ma'am, so what's your message to the youth?
Youth should feel responsible first, responsible as a citizen. Anywhere as a normal citizen, a young person from a village is there, means even from that particular, because party is thinking about our party, especially our party is thinking about Antyodaya. The last person should reach the benefit of the any activity which is taken by the government. So Antyodaya means, so government is thinking to get every benefit to the last person. So if they are benefited by the government, they should have a feeling of responsibility also. So youth also should, it starts from young age. So youth should feel responsible, not to attract with negative messages, negative shows or anything. They should be in a position to. One Rishi as a 14 years old boy can have think about the journalism and leaders, what they can contribute. So any 10th class student can have a thought process of business, society and everything. They can think. They should discriminate the things, good, what is good, what is bad, and then majorly the voting should be changed, and thought process of only power is going to change the system. Money is going to change the system. Especially definition of political party should change youngsters' mind. Because if they act properly, the voting process, the voting pattern will totally change. As a responsible citizen of India, we should think which is good for the country in general, which is good for the village in precise. So So they should think and judge the person with a party. Both the things they should see. Judge the person and then vote as a responsible person. Voting should be changed. Voting pattern should be changed. Thought process of youngsters should be changed. Constructive thought should be there. Constructive thought. Constructive means there are so many parameters will be there for a constructive system. Constructive means broader way we have to think. What is climate change? What individually, what we have to do, what government has to do. So for doing government, what we have to represent them. This is the process. So our responsibility is first process, and bringing the issues to the government is second issue. And to bring that issue into the government system, what should be done? The process should also be taken care of. So these are the three steps one youngsters should take. As in sitting at home also, they can do so many things. If you change one family, the other family will change their family. So it is a change process. So individual youngsters, and they should think, I should complete my education and then prepare for grade 1, grade 2 officer, grade 3 officer, then repeat, and get one job and go and sit in the office room. That should not be there. Everyone should become an entrepreneur. India requires so many entrepreneurs. Youngsters should think in a different way. And many entrepreneurs should emerge from the society. Then from agriculture system to from IT sector. You can do so many things. So our with these thought process, youngsters will become an entrepreneur. They can start one industry, one unit, one simple unit. Simple one pawn shop is started, three people will be employed. So one hotel is started, 40 people are employed. One food truck is started, minimum 5 to 6 people are employed. So like this, out of emerging one entrepreneur from one place, minimum 5 to 6 people are employed. So employment problem will solve. Even if we give government job also, people will not. I have freedom of my own business. Why should I go for working for the government? So that sort of thought process must be there. I don't say that they should not get into government jobs, but everybody, the competition should not be like that. If 100 posts are there, 1 lakh people are applying. If 100 posts are there, 1,000 people are applying, means there is that is fine. For 100 posts, 1 lakh people are 1 lakh people are sitting at home, thinking about, dreaming about these posts. It should not be like that. They should work simultaneously. Work in US culture, I have seen. They work when they do their education also. That is one activity definitely I like very much from. I have seen my sister stays in US. I have seen my sister's children. They used to work when they are in 10th class also. They used to work when they are inter also. They used to work. So working in holidays. So that culture should develop. And if we develop that culture, definitely it will be India will be self-sufficient. So youngsters should work in that direction. So only getting the degrees is not the criteria.
So thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable insights and for taking time to answer my questions.
Thank you.
I hope that the society and the youth will benefit from your message, and I hope to see a better India in the future. Thank you, ma'am.